imagine someone in Fayetteville taking a 30-minute train ride to Crystal Bridges and then returning at the end of the day, or going to the new performing arts centers that are slated for Benton County, and likewise for students commuting in from Bentonville into the university. The train stop would be a 5-minute walk from the university.
That vision could become reality with a light rail transit system in Northwest Arkansas. Light rail is a fixed transportation system with a dedicated right-of-way that moves commuters within a region. It is ideal for peak demand travel times and works as part of a system of mixed modes that could include high-speed rail, commuter rail, even urban streetcars. Northwest Arkansas is growing, with the population projected to double by 2035, reaching more than 1 million people by 2050. The University of Arkansas Community Design Center speculated about that future growth and in 2009 published a study of how light rail might change the region.
So this is a real opportunity to combine transportation planning with good land use planning to actually create a smart growth armature for Northwest Arkansas.
Chase Rainwater, assistant professor of industrial engineering, learned about the CDC project and was interested.
They had a little booklet on Northwest Arkansas Rail, and they got me a copy of that, and a student and I, Jeff Gwaltney, my master's student and I, studied that for a month or so and decided that we were very interested in some of the things they had looked at in terms of Northwest Arkansas Rail and wanted to add some of our quantitative skill sets.
The estimated cost of developing light rail is $690 to $900 million for this region. But light rail offers more efficient transportation, carrying four times the number of passengers as highways. It could also lower the energy footprint by 60% compared to automobile use. Expanded highways cost more to build and create more congestion.
We've created a computer model that simultaneously considers the types of decisions you would need to consider when locating rail. For instance, you may want to know where to put stations, how many stations you want to open, how many trains to put on the track, what times the trains should arrive at each stop.
Historically, this region was linked through a rail system. A light rail system would share the existing tracks in the established right-of-way.
We're a linear region. We're about 32 miles long. All of our major cities and employment centers are located on that right-of-way. Two-thirds of the population within Northwest Arkansas live within 1 mile of the right-of-way. So we have amazing metrics to make this successful.
Using their model, the engineers developed a hypothetical list of 20 stops for a Northwest Arkansas light rail system. It includes Dixon Street, Washington Regional Medical Center, and Northwest Arkansas Community College.
Our model goes above and beyond intuition, and it incorporates a lot of quantitative factors. It incorporates costs, demand levels, where people live now, where they might live, and it's just really complex decision process.
Good cities, both large and small, are characterized by rich transportation ecology in which one has buses, cars, facilities for pedestrians, for bicyclists, as well as rail. Because keep in mind that with rail, at the end of every rail destination, everyone becomes a pedestrian once again. So rail and good compact neighborhood planning go hand in hand.
We really have a decision-making tool that helps city planners, regional officials, maybe federal administrators, take an integrated look at rail planning.
So I think it's fantastic that the university is part of creating these kind of conversations and these kind of projects. We often forget that land-grant universities like the University of Arkansas contribute to state building processes, to regional building processes.